Hello, everyone. I am Caroline, and I want to thank you for watching this video because it's very special to me. And I brought along with me, or I invited, I should say, two very special people for me to chat with me today. And hopefully they can bring you some motivation about living abroad. It's all about living and thriving abroad. And I'm really, really, really excited to have both of them. Normally we just have one of the ladies, but I thought it would be a nice, an interesting chat to have a couple so you can see what it's like to live abroad with your significant other, which a lot of people think is very challenging sometimes because, you know, there's a different element as opposed to living abroad single or traveling single. So I want to welcome Apryl and Rondel Yarbrough. Hello. Thank you so much.
Thanks for inviting us.
Nice intro, Caroline.
So this is really special. And again, I wanted to let everyone see a couple and hearing it, you know, from your perspective. I of course came, you know, single, and so my experience is going to be a little different from yours, but just really quickly, you guys, were you married abroad? Were you married in the U.S., right? Are you both from the same state, or are you from different states?
Actually, a mixture of everything, man, shoot.
I am from Florida, and he is from Michigan. We dated long distance for a while, and when we met
in NOLA, met at a housing conference in NOLA. Yes. Shout out, New Orleans.
Yes. We
got married out the country. Though,
we did. We got married abroad in the Dominican Republic.
Oh, how nice. Okay, so were you planning to move abroad and get married, or was it just something that just popped up, like, let's just do this?
We had both loved to travel, and so even during our long-distance relationship, we often met up in different countries.
It was a prerequisite for both of our dating, you know what I'm saying? You need to have your passport, or right. We ain't dating. So she had her passport, I had my passport, and we just linked.
Yeah, when we got married, we both desired to live abroad. Mm-hmm. We kind of got tired of only taking like extended weekend vacations in certain countries, and we knew we wanted to.
Our vacation time was ridiculous. We were pushing the limits of both of our jobs with our vacation time and our traveling. So eventually we just like, you know what, the hell with it, let's do it. But, you know, in all transparency, we had been planning to get out the country anyway. Our entire dating careers, we were plotting on leaving the United States.
So. We did. We even started our TESOL certification, like, maybe in 2014 or something. Because we knew that one of the easiest ways to get your foot out the door into living abroad would be to teach English. So we thought, you know, that'll be our first avenue. That'll be the easiest way for us to get started with this.
Then he who should not be named got elected. We're like, holla back, people, America. we bounced.
So that's interesting.
So everything we had, got out of there.
That was an interesting dynamic, that meeting, you know, both of you meeting each other, you both had the same dreams and aspirations to live abroad. That was universe, I guess, that brought you together. So I want to ask you something that a lot of people probably would like to know. What has the dynamic been? You know, I mean, I know as a couple, you know, you've got to work things out, and it's not just, okay, I can make any decision I want. You know, working things out between the two of you, how have you found that to be? Easy? Do you think it's easier living abroad and making decisions as a couple as opposed to maybe being back home when you know, things are easier to maneuver.
For us, I feel like it's easy. I mean, it was easier versus being in the United States. Living abroad itself is easier than being in the United States because we don't have a lot of layers of issues to. I don't have to worry about car insurance. Mm-hmm. I don't have to worry. I have so many less stresses that we focus on us and spending time together and enjoying our time together. I ain't got to worry about getting shot or suffocated or pulled over by the police. I have so many less cares living abroad. You know, I hate to sound cliche, but I feel like I'm living the dream, man, for the last, what, 2-3 years?
Almost 3 years.
Yeah. You know, everything is nice. It's butter.
How many countries have you lived? How many countries have you lived in since you left the U.S.?
We've only lived in
four.
We've lived in four. Yeah.
China, Thailand, Colombia, and now Mexico.
Okay, so what are your plans? Will you be nomads forever, or will you settle down maybe? What do you think will happen?
The plan is to find that place that feels like home. So that's why we're traveling and living in different countries until we find that place. For some reason, we think it might be Portugal, and neither of us have been there.
Ain't been to Portugal at all, but I think it's Portugal. Every time we go one spot, we know it's the next spot. It's the next spot.
But, you know, every time we live in a place, it helps us determine, you know, what we want in a place, or, you know, what we don't want, or what we don't want to tolerate any longer. So we do ultimately want to settle down and live abroad.
Currently. We're looking, we do what's called slow travel. So we move from place to place and stay from 6 months to a year, just getting a feel for the place and visiting other countries that are in that locale, pretty much. So, you know, we've been to Cuba. Not that that would be a place of residence, but we plan on checking out some other countries in the area. But then this COVID-19 came on the scene and messed up all of our plans. there are actually still a couple of more cities in Mexico that we want to check out.
So you're in Mexico now, and are you loving Mexico?
We like Mexico, but Merida is too
hot. I mean, I was nervous. We haven't spent this much time in the house, so I was concerned about the electric bill. Like, what is this electric bill going to look like? Is this AC been on blast?
Right.
But it wasn't that bad. So.
Yeah, it really wasn't.
You know, the price is right in Merida. I must say, the price is right. But this heat, no one.
So we do plan on traveling a little bit in Mexico, hitting up Guadalajara, maybe checking out Oaxaca, and a few other places. Guanajuato, I think, just to see climate-wise if we like it better. But Mexico overall, we do love living here.
Yeah, I love the people here. I like the vibe. I like the food, like the fresh produce. You know, Mexico, it's a lot. There is a lot to love about Mexico, for real.
So I guess the next question would be for couples that are thinking of moving abroad. Do you have like a should do this or you should do that kind of a list, or maybe in retrospect, are there things that maybe you would have done differently, or are there things that you think are, I don't know, what are the pluses? And I mean, there's always going to be pluses and minuses, but is there anything that you can think that maybe in the planning stages that you would advise someone, a couple that were thinking of moving abroad, tell them, you know what, I think that you should do this.
I don't know if my advice would be couple specific, but just moving abroad, think about what it is you're looking for in a place that you're living. We kind of had a criteria of things that we wanted in a place, you know, or in a city, you know. It was, and as we travel from place to place, it gets smaller and smaller. But are you looking for a city? Do you like more nature? What kind of cost of living can you afford, and what does that look like in some of the places that you're considering? For us, you know, we know now that we don't want it to be as hot as Merida, but we also know that we want a place.
I must say that I knew that I did not want the heat. You know what I'm saying? But my sweetheart being from Florida, she's like, I want to be someplace where it's warm, where we can get to a beach, where it's a beach accessible, and yada yada yada. And here, man.
But I think you just have to keep that communication open and think about what it is you guys want, but also play off of your strengths. We kind of have roles in our like relationship, and this is like every day, or if we're taking a trip or we're taking a vacation, he is the timekeeper because I lack that skill. I can, time runs away with me, but I'm the navigator.
She's the navigator.
I'm very good at knowing where we are, where we need to go.
Just get about it. Excited about knowing what's next. You know, I'm like, go ahead, sweetheart. I'll play it off the cuff 24/7. But my advice would be stick to the script. Trust yourself. When you originally left, or while you plan on leaving, this is a big step. I'm sure you didn't take it lightly. And you had a plan, an original plan, stick to the script, man. You know what will work. You know what you're looking for. Be adaptable, but don't lose sight of the forest for the trees, man. We had a game plan about what we wanted to do when we left, about the different streams of income that we wanted to create. We've been on the road now for
almost three years,
and we're just getting around to executing our plan. Because, you know, the world is so big, it's so beautiful. You just get so caught up in all of the exotic everything. Because when you travel, once you go outside, you know, there's a mango tree across the street. There ain't no mango trees in Michigan. You know what I'm saying? There's a palm tree over here. It's just so fantastic. You can lose yourself. I think it's important that you, you know, have a plan and execute.
Right. And thing going along with that, you know, our goal is to have some passive streams of income that we're just living off of. And keeping that in mind, some people go abroad and they realize, or they don't have a financial backup plan and it doesn't work out. They have to move back home. So again, you know, sticking to that plan and making sure you have some sort of plan financially to keep you guys abroad or to be able to afford to live your life.
Keep that dream alive, baby. Yeah. Keep it alive. Lots of ways to make money.
Or, you know, have that emergency stash because some people here, I knew, you know, they wanted to leave immediately. If you have the ability, the financial means to, you know, be stuck in some sort of emergency situation and be able to exit, you know, that's important too. So not just living abroad, but if you need to jet.
I think we also, part of our security net is we always got a stash enough to bounce out of any country. We always have to try to keep cash on hand, enough accessible to leave if
should anything happen.
Yeah, the situation.
Well, arises. That's really important. I stress that a lot.
Because
even an example recently in Nicaragua, they had a mass exodus of expats because of the COVID thing that's going on. And it's just running rampant because the government did absolutely nothing to no kind of contingency plan whatsoever. And people were scrambling out of there like crazy. But the repatriation flights, as they call them, were running at like $1,200, $1,300 a pop.
I did not know that, really?
That's what the airlines were
talking about. I thought those were free flights. I thought the repatriation program was all free.
Oh, no. So, like you said, imagine if you have $0 in the bank and you've got a hightail out of town, you know, what are you going to do if you have no money and you're stranded, borders are closed, and this is your only way, and this is literally people's only way out. So that's an important point, you know, make sure that you always have a backup, at least to get out, you know, I mean, a way or credit card or something that you can always get out. Well, any other words of advice for our now this is basically women, but again, I wanted to bring in both of you, any spiritual advice? This is also, I think, in my opinion, somewhat of a spiritual journey, you know, an element to that, you know, being grounded and just following, like you had said, Rondel, earlier about, you know, just stick to, you know, if you said you're going to go to, you know, X place, then just kind of go with it. And I think that that's important for a lot of people to do, just do it. Because when I left, I just picked a place and I went to visit and I said, okay, that's it. That's where I'm going. I didn't doubt myself. I felt good about the decision. Is there a spiritual aspect to traveling abroad, in your opinion, especially when you're, you know, you're as a couple, you're embarking out on this adventure together?
That's a good question.
There's a peace. There's a deep peace that we're centered around and that we stay centered around as a couple. We call that peace Jesus. There's not a... we don't make moves or make like knee-jerk reactions. We talk to each other, feel everything out, and go where we feel the peace. I would also say...
I don't know. I mean, I guess, you know, if you are a religious person, try to stay grounded in your faith, whatever that is. You know, find, listen to that still voice. For us, that'd be the Holy Spirit. But, you know, listen to what that is, but even just being quiet and listening, that's kind of led us to make decisions in certain situations. You were led even to meet up with this person, like someone, the Uber driver.
Mm-hmm.
So that was interesting.
I want to say that too, if I could.
Yeah.
I think it's important, like when you leave the country, I think it's important to link up with other people. Obviously to meet the different people in the different cultures, but you know, your brethren and everything else, you know, through Facebook groups and whatnot, to try to glean wisdom, get some understanding about where you're at and learn, you know what I'm saying, and grow with other people. I think that's a big spiritual element, growing with other people. But it's also important to remember that everybody you meet ain't your friend. Just because people leave the country and you guys have left the country, you guys are out doing your thing, it does not mean that you guys are automatically bonded. You know what I mean?
That's true. I used to think, you know, there's that saying, skin folk are kinfolk,
right,
you know.
Right.
And we, you know, I would be so excited when we saw another black couple or black people abroad because we lived in a place where we wouldn't see black people for weeks.
Oh, black person, hey, come on, come have dinner, come here.
So, but that was a lesson too, you know, walking around, seeing someone doing the head nod or, you know, something like that, and you don't get it back, and you're like,
okay,
you know, is that people have different experiences, you know, and not to get, you know, don't get personal about what other people are experiencing.
Man, don't have no thin skin out here, y'all, it's a big world, find your place in it, and enjoy yourself, that's it, bottom line.
And you are all YouTube celebrities. Tell us about your blogging.
Yeah, YouTube celebrities. I'm enjoying doing these videos, though. This is fun.
What is your blog, in case anyone wants to check it out?
All right, we are the Yarbroughs on YouTube. We are Nomadic Wonder, just pretty much traveling the globe, bringing our different stories about where we're at to you, and letting you know, giving you the lowdown on the different locations that we travel to. We are not rich by any stretch of the imagination. So we kind of piecing it together, letting you see how we're living our lives day to day. And the lessons that we learn and, you know, the beautiful places that we go. In a nutshell. We're living abroad, learning abroad, and loving abroad. And we're just sharing our journey with our viewers.
That's a great way to end our chat. Thank you so much for bringing us your perspective as a couple. It's been really enlightening, and hopefully it'll be enlightening for other couples too that, you know, are trying to navigate through that decision. And it can be a very fruitful and successful one if they do as you say. So thank you so much, you guys. It was very nice. And we'll have to keep watching your adventures on YouTube.
Your adventures inside.
All right.
What is that? Like and subscribe.
That's right. Comment. Thank you.
Drop a comment. We talk to everybody in the comments. Get on. Join the conversation.
Thank you so much, you guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay.